AT&T provides wireless and internet services to millions of people in the United States. What it doesn't own is content, the programs its customers watch on their phones or TVs. This deal could change that.
If their secrets get too big, killing it may be the cost of doing business.
It would give AT&T control of the Warner Brothers film studio. It produced Ben Affleck's new film, The Accountant, which has topped the US box office. It would also give it control of TV channels, HBO and CNN.
I think it's worth understanding this deal against a broader trend in the industry where tech and telecom giants are aggressively seeking to control the content they supply. This deal would be a very significant step in that trend. It would create a media giant. It would be a historic deal, and it would really dramatically reshape the landscape for these industries.
The proposed deal is part of a trend. 5 years ago, telecoms giant Comcast and NBC Universal merged. And last year, AT&T bought DirecTV, creating the largest pay TV company in the United States. The AT&T Time Warner deal will need approval from regulators, which could take more than a year. One issue they'll consider is whether the merger would reduce competition, leading to higher prices and fewer choices for consumers. Republican presidential nominee Donald Trump says he'll block the deal if elected.
As an example of the power structure I'm fighting, AT&T is buying Time Warner and thus CNN, a deal we will not approve in my administration because it's too much concentration of power in the hands of too few.
Members of the Senate say the deal raises questions about the consolidation of the media market in the United States. They want more information about how it will affect consumers. Victoria Gatenby, Al Jazeera.